Hey friends, welcome back to Law Creations. Welcome back to part three of Let's Make a Diorama. And as you can see, I finished my pillar work right here. All this is pretty much all done. Probably took me about an hour to complete. It was a lot of fun. Tedious, but fun. Fun especially seeing it transpire and come to life. So eventually it'll be damaged and it'll be trimmed and look like, broken stonework and weathered. And like I say, this is the ugly stage of making a diorama. And if you didn't catch part one was about making the base. Part two was going over the work of the pillar a little bit. And part three is going to be what I'm going ahead and doing now in making my stone wall. Once again, I took individual pieces of foam and I just cut them. I made them bigger than this particular stonework. And the idea behind making, the stonework is getting it to look ruined, getting it to look like it's old, it's ancient. It's seen many battles. It's seen many wars. That's in my imagination. That's what's going through for this particular piece. It's an old, ruined environment. It's a place where many soldiers, many people lost their lives in battle. And it's a place where orcs and knights and what have you roamed. And it's medieval, and it's just, it's a place where if history could talk, it would have stories to tell. So in my eyes, that's what I'm aiming for this particular piece, is a old, ruined environment. So we have the pillar, it'll be a damaged pillar. We have a wall, it'll be a damaged wall. And over here will be a little bit of a wall that's been damaged and destroyed. And later on, I'll go in with my rock, or I'll go in with a piece of aluminum foil, and I'll texture everything. So all this brick won't look as clean as it does now. I'll texture it. I'll trim it to make it look ruined, and so on and so forth. So that's my imagination for this piece. So what I'm doing now is like I had said, is just laying the stonework. Now there's no right or wrong way to do this as far as I'm concerned. My process is kind of all over the place. It's just going with what I think works and then just running with it. And if it doesn't work, I'll have to make changes. But most of the time, it's fairly successful. Sometimes I do have to make changes and just change my process a little bit. But this is the idea, folks. Like I say, there's no right or wrong way to do this. This is just how I do it. We're going to go with the curve of the diorama for the wall. And we're just going in and just laying down brickwork. That's really all there is to it. And pieces here will be scattered about. And like I say, no right or wrong way. It's all, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So you guys take liberties with your imagination, with your mind's eye, and then just create. Just slop it down, throw it down. Just start adding and just making, and you'll be happy you did, because it's very rewarding. If I can encourage you guys in this hobby, that's what this channel is all about, to encourage you to give it a go, to absolutely give it a try. And if you have 3 3/4 inch figures, make a home for them, make an environment, use your imagination. You have Star Wars figures, go ahead and create some Star Wars dioramas, small ones. If you got the space, make larger ones. But this is just encouraging you to create. Just sit down and create, and you'll be happy you did. So I haven't been making dioramas for very long, maybe a couple years now. And there's a lot of folks out there that are way better than myself. I'm okay with that. I'm pretty happy with what I come up with, and I'm happy with my displays. To me, that's what matters, and I do appreciate when people encourage and like my work. That always goes a long way with me as well. I appreciate kind words. You know, the internet is so full of negativity. It's so full of just garbage that I'm very picky about where I put my work. I don't mind criticism. I kind of encourage it if it's constructive, and if it can be said in a halfway decent way. If I don't like somebody's work, I just, you know, scroll on by, or I don't comment that, you know, it's terrible or anything like that. I just scroll by it and move on, because you know what? To them, it's their hard work. It's what they did. It's what they're happy with. And there'll be 100 other people that will love it. But I usually don't give criticism unless it's asked for. And even then, I'm kind of hesitant to do it, because who am I to criticize another? You know, you get people that comment on people's work, or, you know, or they'll do a thumbs down on a YouTube video, and they probably never done this kind of work before, and they just haters, I guess. I don't know, but I don't get many thumbs downs, which I really appreciate, and to get a thumbs down, that means somebody had to watch a video, so that's a good thing. You know, as long as people watch, and I'm open to thumbs down, I'm okay with that. The only time I ever give a thumbs down to a video on YouTube is if they put it in the listing that it's something that it's not. You know, like clickbait. You click on it and it's totally something different than what the actual title. That, in my eyes, deserves a big old thumbs down. But to criticize somebody's work and somebody's hard effort just because I don't like it, I don't do that. That's just me. And I'm glad there's people out there that do, because it encourages you to be better. You know, it makes you strive to be better. You know, not everybody's going to like your work, and that's just the way it is. But as long as you're happy with it, that's what counts. I guess I'm ranting and raving as I'm making over here. But I think the bottom line is, be happy with what you do. Don't look for people's approval. You know, you create what you want to create. I like making this. I like making environments that have been damaged and war-torn and things like that. Some people like making warehouses, and God bless them. That's awesome. That's what this hobby's all about. If we all made the same thing, what kind of fun would it be? Not much. Not much at all. So you're getting the idea, folks. Just going in and laying down individual bricks. This all will be trimmed, because this is going to start out high, and it's going to be trimmed to where it's broken. And Vandar here is going to have a pretty awesome environment to shine in. That's the idea, guys. I've rambled enough. Not that any of you want to hear me rambling on, but I just wanted to show you, you know, what I'm doing here, and encourage you to give it a go. It's not rocket science. It's rather simple, and if I can encourage one or two guys to or ladies, one or two folks, it's worth making these videos. So this is part three, laying down the brick. I won't do it brick by brick, because I run out of things to talk about, and I just ramble on and sound silly. So anyway, this is the piece so far, folks. I hope you like it. It'll look a lot better painted and weathered and the details later on. Okay? Thank you for watching if you made it this far. And take care and enjoy your night.